This show is created in the Midwest. Our star reviewer is based out of the East Coast. So we are no stranger here to the inherent culture clash of locale. I'm Bratwurst and Pabst, Steve's Lobster and Sam Adams. Today's book adds a greater stressor to that equation, however, money. Edith Wharton is our focus today on Book of the Day. Welcome to Book of the Day here on CPL Radio. This is the show where we talk books and not much else. Although on occasion we do talk other things, so that is wrong. Anyway, our book critic at large is Steve Donahue in Boston, and good day to you, sir.
Hello, everybody.
Edith Wharton.
If digressing is wrong, I don't want to be right.
My goodness. Yesterday was the 70s. Let's keep it in the and see if we can do it. Although our book title today is one from quite some time ago.
Yes, Edith Wharton. Indeed. The Cusp of the Country. Widely seen as one of Edith Wharton's two great masterpieces, along with The House of Mirth. The story of the aforementioned Midwesterner. Undine Spragg.
Great name.
In order to, much as I did myself, sleep her way to the top of society. And just as in my case, it tragically fails.
It is a lifestyle fraught with peril.
It's not easy to do.
No.
For every one of us, it's a failure. But the story is remarkable in a number of ways, as is the particular edition that we've got under our microscope today. Of course, keep in mind, particular editions don't really matter now as much with classics as they ever have in the past.
Sure.
Only because, of course, your friendly neighborhood library has the classics right to hand for free. You have to go in and borrow. But also because books that are out of common domain are free on sites like Project Gutenberg.
Right. Right, absolutely.
And Project Gutenberg carefully curates their ebooks, unlike Google, so the file will be nice and clean, mm-hmm. and everybody reads on their phone anyway. So,
our copy's got a little packing tape on it, probably. So,
well, I wanted to ask about that. The specific edition that we might be talking about a bit today is the Penguin Classic Deluxe Edition.
Relatively new.
It's relatively new. It has a preface by Sofia Coppola.
Interesting choice.
I gather a movie director of some kind.
She it runs in the family.
So maybe the coronavirus Omicron variant gave rise to the pedant variant, and every single scholar on Edith Wharton has died. We have a movie director writing a preface to a deluxe edition, but at least we can give Penguin credit for trying, because if the presence of a movie director writing the preface to the edition doesn't scare you off, certainly the ugliest cover in the history of book covers will certainly do the job.
You're not a fan.
we here at Cedarburg Public Library Radio are here to tell you that the Custom of the Country is brilliant. You should persevere. Despite all the attempts by Penguin Classic Deluxe Edition to get you not to read the book, despite all of that, you should persevere. I'm surprised the thing isn't a pop-up book.
And well, I will flash the cover here right about now. A note to myself, Editor Jeff, later in the day. But I mean, I've seen worse. It didn't completely turn my stomach. they're trying to go for a certain something here, I think. Whether they pulled it off is...
If you've seen worse covers, then you are once again flashing back to all the Meatloaf albums of your youth.
A little bad out of hell here. Country.
Oh my. But the story itself, regardless of packaging, here at Cedarburg Public Library, we're all about judging a book by its cover. but the book itself is brilliant. And the most memorable way in which it's brilliant is the most mysterious way, which is that you love reading about Undine Spragg, even though she's one of the most thoroughly unsympathetic characters in all of literature.
As I read the overview and the synopsis, I was wondering if perhaps they were giving her a short shrift on Wikipedia. Oh, no. Sounds like that's not the case.
She has not a single redeeming characteristic. All she is avarice in human form. So she ruins her relations with her family. She ruins her husband, the husband that she eventually finds. And even when all that is done and she's found another husband, we leave her poised on the brink of ruining him too.
Yes.
She does not learn. She does not introspect. And yet you can't stop reading when that ought to turn off the reader. A character of that reptilian ought to turn off the reader.
In 2022, though, a character with all the traits you just mentioned.
Oh, it's the revenge of Undine Spragg. Yes, you're probably right. Probably
she would
out
do
there
very
the
well.
Is even now green lighting. Yes.
Yes. Would do very
There's
well in this culture.
Green lighted as we speak.
Yeah.
Somebody's writing an essay called We Are All on Dean Spragg.
We may be doing that right here on this show.
I mean, centuries ago, when you got Vanity Fair and you got the character of Becky Sharp, the writer thought, well, I certainly have to balance her with likable characters. This, there's nothing like that. And it doesn't need it.
Yeah.
It's the weirdest thing. I want to chalk it up to Edith Wharton's writing ability rather than the depraved nature of our own era, because no one's ever been able to. In earlier and healthier decades of American history, people still couldn't stop reading about this horrible, horrible person.
Yeah.
So there you go. that is a weird kind of classic.
Yeah. Yeah. She's clearly, I mean, to call her misguided would be, I guess, one thing, but this is like, it sounds like she at least
right.
such a sea of wreckage in her wake.
Right.
This is
she's not misguided. She is, in fact, at many points in the course of the book, correctly guided. She just doesn't care. She doesn't care. And not only that, but when her own horrible personality, her own horrible bottomless greed drives her right to the edge of social and financial destruction, she doesn't learn. There's not a moment of introspection.
Wow.
She just thinks the vessel that I used up was imperfect. I'll find a different vessel.
Do we think Miss Wharton was obviously... Is there satire involved here, or is she just making a very blunt commentary on what possibly America is about?
I wouldn't say that there's satire involved.
Okay.
I would say it's more just pure acid-etched commentary. Edith Wharton knew people like Undine Spragg. They very much did exist, and they very much do still exist. I won't look in the direction of TikTok, but there are still people out there who are just literally soulless sociopaths who only care about having five houses. There always have been such people. And Edith Wharton knew such people. And I think probably at one point in her early life, might have been tempted to become one of such people. This book is born out of anger. It's born out of anger at the path not taken. Anger and relief at the path not taken. I mean, there are other characters in the book. The thing that often gets overlooked by Customer of the Country is that it's full of memorable characters, but they're all in the shadow of this one weird fictional creation.
Monstrous.
In other fictional monstrous creations, there are glimmers of sympathy, right? I mean, Captain Ahab is pretty monstrous. But you can't help feel a little sorry for him as well. And some of the other characters see that as well, but not Undine Spragg. No. So the point that I would want to make about the book as opposed to this edition is that it will hook you. It will pull you right in. No matter what the people are wearing, no matter how old the book is, it will pull you in immediately. It is very, very much alive, as so many of the great classics are. It's just they get a premature burial because they get taught in high schools.
Sure.
But I'm curious to know, what the status is with classics like this in your library system. Do students use them, for instance, or?
There are, you know, there's an interesting cycle that happens wherein people will, just regular folk, will kind of say, I need to add more classics to my diet. And so you will see little spikes, and certainly with the Penguin Works, the way they package them, although, like I said, it sounds like today's a bit more, choice is a bit more controversial when it comes to window dressing. I think that, and certainly a show like this, I mean, to pat ourselves in the back, you described it to a point where I'm sure I'm in the shoes of any of our patrons. I want to read this now. I want to spend some time with this odious individual.
That's what I say right before every show.
And here we are. That is the book of the day. Edith Wharton, the Midwest East Coast connection. She is trying to better herself by any means necessary, it sounds like. And there's something very delicious about that. Sign me
That's
up.
A very good word for the book.
Yeah.
It's a delicious book.
Oh, perfect Christmas fare too, because I'm all about counter programming. All right, everybody, that is your book of the day. That book can be found in our library system. We don't have one on site here at Cedarburg Public Library. I'm going to work on that, as I always do after these shows. Thanks, everybody. Thank you, Steve.
Bye-bye.